How do you share your calendar? Screenshot? Or export to Excel, copy paste? No, there are many nice ways of sharing your calendar. Let's have a look at them. Now, when there are a lot of meetings, obviously many people have calendars where you can't find free time. It's crowded. Fair enough. That's how your work is. But visually, it should be possible to at least segregate which ones are for HR, which ones are for finance, which ones are for compliance. Or if you are senior, how much of this work I'm doing is strategic versus some of it is operational, tactical. So basically, you need to decide what categorization you need. So right click on a meeting, there are categories. If you have never created categories, they'll be shown as blue, red, green, something like that. But you can rename them. There are 25 colors to choose from. So create the categories which make sense to you and then apply that color coding so that at a glance you can get a view of what kind of meetings I am arranging, what kind of meeting I am attending. And by the way, if you want to filter out all the meetings I have done with HR, for example, now you can use that category as a search or filter condition as well. And lastly, these color code which you created can be used not just with calendar entries, but also with tasks and emails and even contacts. So that color coding stays with you mentally throughout Outlook. And it's visible on the mobile app as well. As an organizer, you need to track who is attending, who is refused, who has not even responded. I hope you know how to do that. Once you have sent the meeting request, open it again and you will see a tracking tab where you will see a list of people and what is their response. And now that same tracking information is visible inside a Teams meeting as well. If you get a meeting request, your calendar is free and you refuse, that's called unprofessional. Am I right? Now look at it the other way. Your calendar is empty. What is the other person thinking? Oh, this guy has nothing to do. May I say, wait, no. Really? Is that professional? That is also equally unprofessional, but we can't talk about that. So what is the solution? Block time every day, every week, whatever you want to do your work. So you're taking an appointment with yourself to do your own work. Is that professional? Absolutely. Is that ethical? Absolutely. Are you doing that right now? No. So start doing it. That's called time management. Recently, Microsoft added an AI-based feature called Meeting Insights. What does it do? See how technology evolves. You are in a meeting. What will you have to do? You'll have to prepare for the meeting. So you'll have to read some mails. You'll have to find some collateral files. Takes time, isn't it? Now, AI has come to rescue. AI. So Meeting Insights button, if you see, click on it. Now it has already found the related mails and related files, so your time is saved. Less effort, more impact. In the rare case that the meeting is interesting, you're going to take notes. Am I right? 6 months later, how are you going to find those notes? That's the commonest problem people ask me. Answer is staring at you for a long time. Go to the meeting request in the calendar, right click, send to OneNote. Now, OneNote list appears, choose the notebook and take notes there. They are already linked. So 6 months later, you go to the calendar, go to the meeting, right click, same button. It will find the notes for you. Problem solved. But there is one more thing. While you are taking notes in the link page, aren't there going to be action points about the meeting? So you have written something, but that's not an action point. That's notes. It's just a paragraph. So right click there and choose that flag. Now it becomes a task in Outlook. So Outlook started OneNote. OneNote is talking back to Outlook. That's called efficiency. That's called integration. In fact, we have a detailed video for both these topics. One is for OneNote, the link is above, and task management, which I've already shown you before. So far, we have seen how to arrange a meeting and how to manage your time and participate in the meeting. Now, what happens after the meeting? After the meeting, there will be some follow-up. There will be some collaterals. All that again comes back to dumping ground inbox. So what is the idea? The idea is if it was a Teams meeting, this problem is already solved. Why? Because as soon as the meeting is over, it becomes a chat. And now without sending a single mail to each other, all kinds of follow-up you can do in the meeting chat itself. It's a great feature. And sadly, most people either don't notice it at all, or if they notice it, they hate it by saying, hey, why is it crowding my chat? In fact, remember, if there is an irritating feature, it has to be really useful to humanity. In fact, the Teams best practices video discusses this in detail. Let's talk about sharing calendars. Most common scenarios, I am the boss and I have an assistant and I have shared it. Fine. Now, as a boss, I have a problem. I want an appointment which I don't want my assistant to see. Not a problem. There's a private button. Click that. Now, assistant will not see it. Simple. Now, let's talk about from organizational point of view. Every organization has a list of holidays. They have a holiday calendar, but very often it is in a Word document, PDF, Excel, God knows where. It is everywhere except in the calendar, and it's called holiday calendar. How to create that calendar? Go to SharePoint, create a calendar, put your holidays there. Now, create a shared link and send it to all employees. Ask them to click on the link, look at the calendar. Every day they don't have to go there. First time they have to go there, and then there is an option sync with Outlook. Once they do it, that calendar will integrate with their Outlook on desktop, and next time onward they never have to go to that web page. Now it becomes a separate calendar in their list of calendars itself. So now they can see their calendar side by side with the holiday calendar. Wow. And every time there is a send receive, if there is a new holiday added, deleted, whatever, it's going to sync. This is the best way to share holiday calendars, event calendars, research calendar, whatever you have. Central to periphery. Now that I have multiple calendars, what is going to happen? Look at this. One calendar, mine, another calendar. That date is same. I'm seeing the same date twice. It's confusing. So if you want to avoid that confusion, but keep them separate, this is the arrow. This is your best friend. It's called overlay mode. Now both of them get merged. The color coding is still there. Now when you have two calendars, overlay mode is okay. Side by side is also okay. If I add 3, 4, it's getting crowded and crowded and confusing. So if I add more than 4, look at this. This is miraculous. Everything changed. You first got confused, but then you will be very happy. Because what you're seeing right now is something like a Gantt chart where every row is a calendar and on top you see date and time together. Think about it. In fact, for a regular calendar also, you can go to schedule view to understand things, start date, end date kind of thing, a mini Gantt chart. Now, another common and boring scenario is one boss tries to meet another boss. Both are busy, both are important. So two assistants are just doing ego clashes to block their time. The correct way, create a new mail, insert calendar, choose the time frame. Obviously, you just want to show free busy time. Choose the format and click OK. Now see what happens. There's one format, there's the other format. You choose which one, send it. Of course, there's a snapshot as of now. After the mail is gone, if you change something, that's not going to reflect. But it's so much simpler than going on phone and saying, oh, 2 to 3 or 3 to 4. So try it out tomorrow. So here is another joke. In order to block time, people are wasting time. Have you seen that paradox? Example, I'm the boss. I have to do one-on-one review with 20 of my direct reports. I have to do it every 6 months, whatever. Now I or my assistant has to block those 20 half an hour slots. Again, the same story repeating itself 20 times. And this is going to happen for so many bosses. Imagine, is this efficient from any angle? No. Is it familiar? Yes. So what's the solution? You'll be surprised that solution has been sitting there for a long time. It's a part of Office 365. So go to office.com, log in, go to that 9 dots, that's called waffle menu, by the way, all apps, and you will see bookings. So what does booking apps do? It eliminates all this manual intervention, simplifies the work. What are you going to do? Appraisal. How much is the duration? Half an hour. Very good. But every day your half an hour is going? No. I'm saying only these days and during these times, these slots I'm going to make available for my subordinate to talk to me. Fair enough. After all this is done, it will give you a link. Send that link to everyone. When that person clicks on the link, they will see available dates and available slots. They click on the slots, put their details, and end of story. Now what is going to happen? Your calendar is blocked, that person's calendar is blocked, nobody talked to anybody. And the next person clicks on the same link, that slot is gone. Imagine how simple this is. I know some people use Calendly and other tools, but this is sitting right there in Office 365. And by the way, you can use this not just internally, externally as well. Maybe you're a consultant, you're a lawyer, you're a dentist, you're a gym instructor. You can have exactly the same thing exposed to your customers as well. And in some countries, even payment integration is available. Now, this is a thought which has never come to you probably. We attend hundreds of meetings, but have you analyzed how many meetings, of what type, whom did you meet, what was the duration? No. All the time we are making reports of data, meetings itself is data. So how do you analyze it? If you are interested in data analytics, there is a very nice way. In Excel, as well as in Power BI, get data, other has an option called exchange. Do you know what that exchange is? It's your mailbox. So just go there, log in. It shows you mail, calendar, everything. Now you choose calendar, import the data, and then analyze it yourself. Very nice. But then Microsoft has already done it for you. Where is it? All apps, Viva Insights. Now, depending on the license you have, you may or may not see it, but those who see it absolutely jump at it. What does it show you? It shows you various types of analysis about the way you are interacting with other people, meeting, chat, attachments. And in the context of meetings, it gives you a very nice analysis of meeting habits and meeting details. So explore it, learn from it, and improve the quality of your meetings and your work-life balance. So less effort, less stress, more impact. I know this video is about time and it's a long video, but in order to manage time, you need to spend this time. Apply it intelligently and tell me how it impacted your life in comments. If you like it, share it with your colleagues, friends, and loved ones, because you can't manage your time alone. Everyone has to understand the same principles. Then it becomes collaborative efficiency. And take few seconds of your time now to click on the subscribe button, bell icon, and there is a thank you button as well. Why don't you explore that? So till next time, take care. Bye-bye.